On March 9, 2022, the dangerous Mount Merapi volcano on the island of Java in Indonesia erupted, producing a series of small lava dome collapses. This sent fragments of blocky lava tumbling downslope, forming what is known as a lava avalanche. Throughout the evening, earthquake and harmonic tremor activity around the volcano increased, signaling that a larger eruption was imminent. Then, at approximately midnight local time, the sky lit up due to a sudden explosion with fragments of lava. This explosion released a lengthy superheated cloud of ash and volcanic gases known as a pyroclastic flow, which traveled to the south. The pyroclastic flow traveled 4,900 meters or 16,100 feet down a river channel carved by previous events, depositing layers of superheated rock. Over the next several hours, six additional less energetic pyroclastic flows occurred, once again flowing down the same path. What had just occurred was a typical eruption from Mount Merapi, albeit it was slightly larger than normal. Luckily, no one was injured due to this eruptive sequence, primarily due to the lack of people in the adjacent river channels and the time the eruption occurred at. Regardless, the evacuation radius has now been extended from 5 to 7 kilometers from the erupting vent, meaning that you should under no circumstances approach the volcano within this area. Several videos have been posted of people investigating the still-steaming superheated rock deposited by the pyroclastic flows in the river channels. Please do not do this, as additional pyroclastic flows are quite likely, and no person can outrun a 60 km/h superheated gas current. This latest eruption occurred after a series of thunderstorms which dumped approximately 6 centimeters of rain on Merapi's summit. The rainfall may have caused additional erosion to the lava dome, allowing for pressure to be released in an explosive manner. If this rainfall had not occurred, an eventual eruption still would have taken place, albeit probably a week or so later. Heavy periods of rainfall are known to on occasion trigger large volcanic eruptions in the case of ones with unstable lava domes, such as the December 2021 eruption of Semeru. The lava dome which experienced a partial collapse was Merapi's central dome. Another lava dome exists on the southwestern slope of the volcano, but has not been the primary site of recent activity. Overnight, and within a several kilometer radius of Merapi, a light dusting of ash fell from this explosive eruption. This dusting of ash is consistent with a VEI-1 eruption, which just happens to be the designation given to Merapi's ongoing eruption. Its eruption has been ongoing since December 31st of 2020, producing intermittent lava avalanches and pyroclastic flows similar to what just occurred. If you live to the north or east of Merapi, you should be slightly concerned but not too worried about its latest activity. Since much of the volcano collapsed to the southwest 2,000 years ago, almost all of its eruptions since have been funneled in that direction. While a larger eruption could theoretically send pyroclastic flows away from the collapse scar, a Plinian eruption would be required, much like Merapi's 2010 eruption, and there are no signs of such a voluminous eruption being imminent. Currently, the alert level of the volcano is at 3 on a 0 to 4 scale, indicating an ongoing moderately sized eruption. In the next several days to weeks, more pyroclastic flows are likely, which will generally get funneled to the south. Due to the frequency of rainfall in the area, remember to stay at least 100 meters away from river channels during the next series of storms. This rainfall will wash away part of the still superheated pyroclastic flow deposits, forming near boiling temperature floods of acidic material known as lahars. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Veruca Salty, for supporting this channel.